Victor Hickey. And he's going to share an experience that he had in his life. And I want you to know that it takes a lot of courage and it takes a lot of bravery to share what he is going to be sharing with you this morning. I want to take you back. First off, he's 19 years old. And Hunter writes, at 19 years old, I was suicidal and thought I had no one to turn to. I spent a week in the hospital and in the ICU on suicide watch. You obviously were depressed. You were anxious. You had anxiety, but you decided to turn that feeling around and started to think about doing something to help not only yourself, but other people.
Exactly.
What was it when you were in there that gave you the motivation to get out and to look for the light?
God, for real, was a big factor. And just, I've always had a compassion for just helping people. And just, if I could, I saw where I was almost at a dead end. And if I could help just one person, then I knew it would be worth it.
Yeah, the holidays, they bring a lot of pressure. I mean, for me, I feel, you know, pressure, anxious, and have like anxiety, and sometimes I feel depressed. And some people really need to take a personal inventory about where they are if they are depressed. And a way to do that is to just to talk to somebody. And you can go to groups like the one that you've started, Hunter,
right, called
Invisibly Shaken. I think that's a really neat name. Tell us about your group.
Okay, Invisibly Shaken. It's Invisibly Shaken because no one really knows you have a problem until you talk about it.
Yeah.
And I was depressed and my family didn't know about it. And so what you do is you simply just write to us on Facebook, or you can mail to us your story. And it's completely anonymous because a lot of people are focused on being biased or, oh, they'll think differently of me.
Sure.
But it's not like that. It's anonymous and we just want you to talk about it because it's the best form of healing.
It is. And I think that, I don't know if you knew our meteorologist, Don Harmon.
Oh, yeah. I apologize for you.
But thank you. It's been, the next Tuesday, it'll be 3 weeks since he took his own life, and he suffered from depression. And so we've been talking about this. We've been getting it out in the open. We've been learning more about depression. We're hearing stories like yourself, Hunters, and, you know, where some people can be in their lives and how they can reemerge from it and go on to live productive lives. What do you think your experience, and what have you learned from all of this experience going through depression and then also starting this group to help?
There's nothing like just talking to somebody. It's just, it's a sense of relief. And if you can just help one person, then that's all it's worth. And that's that's what I've learned. Is just, if you can touch one person, it doesn't matter the money or how much you have to go through. But once that person's reached, then that's a life saved.
It's free?
Yeah,
the group is free?
Everything's free.
Real quick, tell us what you want to do.
I want to reach nationally and reach a nonprofit stature within the United States.
And eventually you want to become a police officer, right?
I do. I want to be a police officer for the KCPD, actually.
Really?
Yes, sir.
All right. Hey, Hunter, good to see you. Thanks for sharing your story. It took a lot of bravery. Wish the best for you and Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Time now is 9:52, and this is Fox 4 News at 9.